Hello, irate commuter. Back again, bitch. I just want to talk about Lords of the Fallen. That's what I'm playing right now. I want to talk about, I suppose, how it's being compared. This is an older game. I mean, I got it for like $16. I'm very happy with the price that I paid. And it's a good game. Don't get me wrong. I'm not knocking it at all. But there are comparisons of about this game with Dark Souls. And I can see it on the surface. I can see that comparison. But I've played about maybe 12 hours. Put 12 hours into Lords of the Fallen. And it's really more like an old series called Arcania. Gothic. I played Arcania 4 Gothic, which had awful controls, and I think I made a video about it a few, like 6 months ago or something. This game is nothing like Dark Souls at all, except in terms of maybe the Estus flasks and get them getting strengthened, and like the overall look to some degree. But that's where it stops. It's more like Arcania. But with much, much better controls. it's really fairly linear game. It's not a big world. Now, I didn't even know this, that I only put like about 12 hours in. I might be wrong, maybe a little bit more. And I'm at the last boss already. That's very depressing. You know, when it wants to be I've seen interviews with programmers on this game that they are very happy with the comparison to Dark Souls. The problem is that Dark Souls has larger worlds, more interconnected worlds, which this does, Lords of the Fallen. But my thing is that if you actually play the game as far as I have, you notice that there are a lot of the world is actually really small. It's not large in the least. It's really comprises of about less than 10 areas, if I'm not mistaken. That might be wrong, but it's not far off. Whereas a game like Dark Souls or Bloodborne has a lot more. It has about 20. You know, or more areas to, you know, explore and fight bosses. I'm sorry, fucking traffic is ridiculous today. These fucking assholes are flying all over the place like fucking pricks. I got a guy with a fucking wagon, not a station wagon, but he has like a wagon behind him. I'd show you, but I might crash in doing so. Anyways, it's a really small game. It's a good game. Story's okay. You play as Henrik, I think, and some priest, Halcon, I think, frees you. You're a criminal, and you get freed from prison to help him fight these creatures from another dimension called Rogar, I don't know, whatever. And that's it. You gotta help him. And the story evolves. You meet a woman named Yetka. And, you know, you gotta lead, you know, the soldiers against the fucking, you know, whatever. You know, it's like the same fucking story every fucking time. You're a criminal, and you gotta redeem your acts. You redeem your acts by fucking slaying demons. But anyways, graphics are good. They're not great. I'm playing it on the PlayStation 4. They're kind of cartoony. Like cartoony bad. And again, another comparison to Dark Souls. Dark Souls is not cartoony. It at all. It's hype. It's realistic. I was about to say hyper-realistic. To some degree. Bloodborne, yeah, and I'm sure Dark Souls 3 is going to be hyper-realistic. But this game is kind of cartoony. Some of the enemies are goofy. And just large, but not really too difficult. I'm sorry. Jesus fucking Christ. you know, it's like, I don't know. I'm not knocking it. It's just kind of strange when enemies are fucking. Anyways, I'm level 60. I'm just gonna say I'm level 60, and I'm fucking annihilating everything I come across, even bosses. There are about 8 or 9 bosses in the game, just kind of a letdown, and you will blaze through them. There's only one boss that really gave me any problems whatsoever, and it's because I had no healing items every fucking time I tried to fight this thing. I had like 0 healing items. And that was it. It wasn't because he was particularly difficult. It was the champion boss, if you guys want to know. It was because I had no fucking healing potions. Anyways, game is fun, but it's not memorable. I might do a playthrough, a second playthrough. I typically don't, because games like this are kind of one and done, in my opinion. But it's a fun game, and, you know, I mean, you can buy it used anywhere for between 15 to 20 bucks, and it's absolutely worth that. You'll be playing it for about a week if you're like I am, if, you know, you're like me, and you just blast, you know, you fly through games, and then you flip them and resell them. So, anyways, it's Dark Souls super light. It's not hard. I think in the entire game, about 20 hours in, or 12 to 15 hours in, I maybe died 4 times. Whereas the first 15 to 20 minutes of Dark Souls, you're going to die about 4 times. Just something to think about. All right, guys. Have a good one. Bye.